All right, so I finally got tired of my old phones because they're getting interference from the router, some clicking on one of them. One of my old 900 megahertz phones was no interference, but it was just old and the number four didn't work, so you couldn't call anybody with number four in their number. And then, like, the third phone was a 5 gigahertz model, and I just couldn't hear out of it anymore. Not because I'm aging, my hearing's fine, it's because the phone was just getting, I think, old. So jumped up to the 6 gigahertz model, which are guaranteed not to click because of the router. That's excellent. And also there's only one station and four handsets. So you've got this great set of handsets that I'll show you. And you don't see anything great, but they're nice, nicely weighted and very handy and comfortable to use, and lots of features. You can change all the tones and the melodies and the answering system, and it has a lot of things you can set up, and it's very user friendly. So, oh, and oh, it kind of just, I'm talking to YouTube. You said you didn't want to be on it, so I'm not even going to walk back there. Okay, I'm going out in the garage. My fans, all six of them. Okay, out into the garage where there's a little more light and maybe you can see me better. And also, I think out into the garage where maybe I feel a little bit more comfortable. The last video where I was taking my medication and stuff, some of my friends were like, "Dude, if I didn't know you better, I'm thinking maybe a little gay or something." Not that that's a bad thing. Not that that's wrong. It's just that it's not really me, and I didn't realize that I came across that much that way to people who don't know me. I hope not, but if it's true, I mean, you can't help acting or using the mannerisms that you use. I don't know. I don't know what to say about that. So I'm out in the garage where I feel more comfortable, and I put away the old phone. Actually, I put one of the old phones out in the garage because my daughter likes to talk on the phone and rollerblade, and it's like, hello, how many times have you dropped that phone? Not with the new phones. You can use this garage phone, and it's this one, which is just a cheap Uniden model, 2.4 gigahertz, which did not get interference from my router, although I think the router works on the 2.4 gigahertz frequency range. And yes, I talk fast. My wife talks fast. I talk fast, and I think my oldest daughter's starting to talk fast, but she's 13, so you can't tell what she's saying. Anyway, right? Right. So, oddly enough, so this is not interesting, but something to talk about. My first cordless phone, not my first cordless phone, but one of the best cordless phones we had was the 900 megahertz, and it was a Panasonic as well. Let me show you that one real quick. Yay! Yay! But look at that antenna. It's huge! It's huge! Metaphor? I don't know. And it didn't get any interference from the router as well. But I'm glad to be back with Panasonic phones because they're comfortable. And Tim, I think these newer ones have a 13-hour talk time, which is going to be very helpful with my 10-year-old. She will literally talk on the phone for 2 hours straight, kill the batteries in the phones, and then we go to use the phone, and it's like, beep, beep, it's dead. Can't be charged. Can be charged, but shouldn't have to charge your phone after 10 minutes picking it up. It's because your 10-year-old is killing it. Anyway, what else do we have on the agenda here? Let's look back at the workbench. So, mandatory coffee. Yes, this is the afternoon coffee, which is a strong European blend, as opposed to the morning coffee, which is a slightly, well, it's just Folgers. Haha. Cordless drill. Yay. Painter's tape. Useful. Smokes. Not useful, but good for weekends when you're mowing. Safety glasses, perfect. Loads of earplugs. You have to have earplugs, safety glasses, and earplugs when you're doing things. Harbor Freight, 99 cents. Best scissors you will. I think it's 99 cents, or maybe $1.99. These scissors kick ass. If you use them right, otherwise they pinch your fingers. So, I put all the other phones in a box. I think I'm gonna try to recycle them. I'll recycle the batteries. And I think if we send the phones to school with one of my kids, they have some kind of electronics recycling program going on through the schools, and they get money or something like that. I just got back from Thor. Oh my God. I went there and I expected it to be bad. I just assumed it would be bad. I'm not sure who played Thor. He looked familiar, but he just looks like Brad Pitt to me. Like, well, a young Brad Pitt. But I was like, wow, Ellen Page and Natalie Portman, they did an amazing job. And Anthony Hopkins played Thor's dad, Odin. I think what saved the movie was a decent script and three really good actors. Thor did a good job, but he had to play Thor, so he had to be godlike, I suppose. But I think the really good acting, I don't remember who played Thor's brother. He did a really good job, too. But what I was going to say is what saved the movie was those three fine actors, Ellen Page, Natalie Portman, Anthony Hopkins. They brought it up another level. If they hadn't have been there, I think we would have been looking at a bomb. So I was really pleasantly surprised, and I'm going to say so on Facebook, and I don't care who reads it. It was good. Looking forward to Green Lantern. Yeah. Oh, check it out. Can you see that? Throwing stars. Well, there's a blown piston. If you buy some brands of weed eaters, they have a half shaft. And the half shaft, if it gets off balance, it just a half of a crankshaft. So the crankshaft stops and doesn't go all the way through. It's only held on by one side. If it gets off balance too badly, you're gonna throw it. And that's what happened to me. I didn't tighten down my flywheel. If you don't tighten down your flywheel, you're screwed. You'll mess up your piston bad. But that's what happens when you have half a crankshaft instead of a full crankshaft. I think most of the time I'm running on half a crankshaft. Throwing stars from when I was I ordered those when I was like 14. I ordered them out of a magazine because, like, you know, the internet was not really existent. It was in its infancy. So, probably running out of time. This will take forever to upload. You want to see some dirt? Dirt! Bags of dirt. Got lots of gardening plans to do after the wife and kids fly off to Germany this morning. When they fly off to Germany at the end of June, then I will be free to do my gardening plans without my wife saying, oh, you're back, watch your back. Which is probably true. I should watch my back because it hurts sometimes. But I'm going to garden no matter what. I love digging the dirt. I think that's it. I look forward to watching this, and I hope other people will watch it too, and give me some feedback. I'm not sure what I want to do with these. I would like to do something more interesting. But what happens usually is when I hit summertime and I'm starting to work on my lawnmowers, doing minor tune-ups or sharpening the blades, or I've got a leaf, one of my leaf blowers or one of my weed, I got two weed eaters and two leaf blowers. I don't know why, but I also have two lawnmowers. I don't know why I have double of everything. It just kind of happens over the years. My best lawnmower is running on like 17 years old now, and my other one's probably 14 years old, and they just keep on running because I don't change the oil. Don't believe in it. I'll explain that in a different video. Just top off your oil. Don't even bother changing it. Don't worry about it. In your lawnmowers, in your car, it's a totally different story. Don't get me wrong. Change your oil in your vehicles, 3,000 miles, or 5,000 if you're running synthetics, might as well. But in your lawnmowers and stuff, forget about it. Oh, I know. I think when I go to work on the carburetor on I think the leaf weed eater. I think the weed eater has a bad carburetor or some plugged jets or something. I've really got to work on that. Take it apart and work on the diaphragm and things. Just see what's wrong with the carburetor because it's just not working right. Just won't flow gas. I can't get gas through the carburetor. So there's something being blocked there. So maybe this summer when I take that apart, then I'll do another video, and you can see how to fix that, if I fix it. If I don't fix it, then I won't put the video up. I want to look like a hero. A man's man. Okay. I got so much to talk about sometimes. Real quick. Oh, no, I don't want to talk about that. That goes back to the reason. I should have told you why I was taking the medications. Or showed you, well, there's all kinds of ideas for videos. I should go into why I have to take so much medication every morning and every evening.
But that's totally different video. All right. Jeez. Isn't it weird how you save things from your kids? My daughter, oldest daughter's 13, and I think she made this when she was probably like 5. She was in preschool, so real quick, watch this. I don't know, I mean, it's just a monkey. That she colored a monkey and then drew some stuff around it. Yeah, good stuff. All right, I hope I haven't flipped you around too much and made you dizzy. But the garage is a good environment for me, as far as there's a lot of things in the garage that I can show you, and then there's stories behind those things. And that makes it more interesting and fun for me, and maybe even interesting and fun for you. Because especially for guys that keep crap in the garage, just, you know, every time you walk into your garage, you're like, yeah, there's my crap. Like this. Let's see. There's a nice big heavy vise, your circular saw, and the bench grinder. And, you know, just as I walk around my garage, I can just look at things and go, oh, yeah. I got this somewhere, and I used it on something, and then someone put their eye out. Yeah, it could happen. You don't know. All right. Thanks for watching. And I will talk to you later.